Okay, so my unit just spent some time out at Fort Bragg, and let me tell you, some of us got very red, okay? Sunburns are a thing, okay? Whether you are in the military and you're kind of forced to be out there, whether you just love being outside, you're doing athletic stuff, you love camping, hiking, the reality is that sunburns happen, and they are a thing that should be avoided at all costs if we can. And we got to talk about how to treat them appropriately if they end up happening. So let's kind of talk through sunburns. First of all, you can actually get sunburns on days when it doesn't look like there's a ton of sun out because it's a radiation thing. It's not necessarily a visible sunlight thing. So it can still happen. So I think that probably a huge proportion of people who should be wearing sunscreen are not on a regular basis. The other thing is, let's talk about what sunscreen means. The dermatologists tend to recommend sunscreen that has an SPF rating, a protection factor rating of at least 30 or more. It's important to think about places that a lot of people don't, right? Most people, if they get sunscreen, they'll put it on their arms, their back, whatever. A lot of people don't get up into the neckline. If you're someone who happens to have a hard part, or if you've got actually really, really thinning hair, you might need to think about that. A lot of people miss ears. Ears, people don't like to get all that gunk in their ears. You want to get into ears. And like up on the nose and up on the forehead as well. It's annoying to have it above your eyes because I know it can sting a little bit sometimes, but you got to think about those things. I have spent time with the dermatology department at a VA, and a lot of our older folks who've had a lot of sun exposures are getting a lot of suspicious skin cancers taken off of ears, noses, foreheads, up on the top of their head where the hair has been thinning out, where they got sunburned a lot. You really want to protect yourself. It's not just about the pain of this week when you get sunburned. It's about getting skin cancer later on in your life. So that is an important thing. Please do not forget. The other thing to think about is that most people, when they put on sunscreen, they'll put it on first thing in the morning, and then they don't think about it again. If they're out for 12 hours, they might put it on again later in the afternoon after dinner or something like that. But sunscreen really should be put on again every couple hours if you're out moving around and sweating. That's multiple times per day to put more sunscreen on to reduce your odds of getting a serious burn and reduce your odds of ending up with a skin cancer later on in life. All that sun exposure does add up. Now, what do you do if you get a sunburn? Because if you are like me, you are a melanin challenged and you are just kind of genetically predisposed, I'm going to get sunburns. If I'm outside, it's just going to happen. How do I deal with them? You probably have heard this. Your mom probably knew about this. Aloe vera is like aloe vera creams, whatever. Those are pretty good at helping with the sting of sunburn. That and just multiple applications as much as you can of just cool water. Cool water on burned skin just feels so good. And you want to try and dab dry. And just hopefully you can get that moisture to just stay in without irritating that burn as much as possible. Things that you do not need to be doing, okay? I don't know where these came from, but you do not need to be putting Vaseline on burns. You do not need to be butter on burns. No, don't do that. You don't need to be going and buying a ton of crazy expensive creams and all that sort of stuff. If you've just got a simple sunburn, for the most part, aloe vera water and trying to limit your sun exposure again in the future are really the best things that you can do. Again, try to get a hold of the sunburn ahead of it and not let it happen. But then just do the basic care afterwards and just know that it's going to hurt for a little bit. Now, if your sunburn gets really bad, I grew up in Florida. I did track. I have seen blisters on people from sunscreening. Most people know the story, like, you know, somebody who fell asleep in the sun or something like that. And people have gotten blisters. Again, you might have seen my foot video. The goal with blisters is not to pop them if you can avoid it, because whatever is underneath that blister is still sterile, and the inner layer of that skin is going to be weaker and more prone to infection than the outer layer. So if it's possible, try to avoid popping them. But if it starts to get to the point where the actual pressure on that blister is enough that you feel you just have to, please consider talking to a doctor if you can. If not, you just physically can't get to one. You want to do small pinholes to release some of the fluid and try to not de-roof that and create open wounds any more than you can, okay? But again, the absolute best thing in most cases is to just let that blister be and let it heal itself, because they will, over time, reabsorb all that fluid. One more thing, as we were talking about myths about sunburns. And I know that people get very sensitive about these topics, so I just want to be very, very clear that I'm trying to help everybody here. There are no jokes in this. I actually know people who have believed in the past that folks with darker skin can't get sunburns. I know people who have thought African Americans could not have sunburns. That is crazy. And every single human can actually get sunburns. It is true that those of us who are very pale tend to get sunburns faster, and we are more prone to get these skin cancers associated with those sunburns. That is an actual real thing. But if you give yourself enough sun exposure, you absolutely, regardless of how much melanin you have, regardless of how dark your skin is, you can get a sunburn. So you need to protect yourself too. You should still wear sunscreen because you still have some risk, less than me, right? But you still have some risk of getting skin cancers and getting sunburns. And that is not something I would wish on anybody. So please, regardless of how protected you think you might be by just your natural skin color, it is important that you use sunscreen.